In 2001, the village of Braxton Heath was awarded Britain's Friendliest Village, and since receiving the award has become a regular hotspot for tourists and even holidaymakers. In this series, we take a look at the eccentric and sometimes touching lives of the people that inhabit this tranquil haven. Just what is their secret in maintaining such a happy and friendly way of life? We met some of these people to find out how. Brian Sutcliffe has been the community's home watch leader for over 17 years and has won awards for his services to the village, including his ban on begging in the village square back in 92 and his introduction of a 6 o'clock closing time in the car park due to local boy racers running amok in their cars. In his latest venture, he's trying to introduce a ban on all live music in pubs and clubs and the introduction of soundproof glass. His sometimes opinionated and controversial views on the running of the community haven't always been a hit with residents of the area. We meet Brian to find out just why, in his words, he is the heart and soul of the village.
So, Brian, what makes you such an integral part of this community?
Well, Neil, it's a good question to start off with.
It's David.
Is it?
It's fine. We'll edit it out, but yeah, it's David.
Right. Do you know what? I've got a terrible memory for names. Take Marion, for example, at number 23. I constantly call her daughter Paula. It's not. It's Barbara. Can you believe that? Speaking of Marion, I've not seen her for a good 3 weeks. She's been bedbound. Could be longer, could be a month, but because she's bedbound, not seen her around. Apparently she's been lying in her own shit for the past week. Awful business. Smelly business. Anyway, we'll move on from there. I don't want to gossip about residents. It's not my thing, it's not my bag. But I will do my bit to help. I will do my bit. I'm not going to touch the shit. It's a line.
Crime in Braxton Heath. That's not right.
Well, there's very little of it, Neil. Have a look around you. It's very peaceful. It's very quiet. That's not just down to me. I mean, a lot of it is the work I've put in, certificates. But a lot of it's down to the residents as well, their contributions to the area. The police, yeah, they've tried. I ring them. Right, that's it. It's the second time. Sorry about that. Shouldn't happen again.
What happened there?
Well, I got the ball off him. Just took it off him.
Does that happen a lot around here?
Second time today. So, anyway, let's just, you know, I think I told him. I think he knows that he's done wrong. So.
Every morning, Brian does his daily rounds of the village, making sure residents are okay and scouting out any problems that may be an issue so he can raise them in the home watch meetings he runs.
I think it's quite good to have a high presence as home watch leader. Just to be seen around, walking, if anybody needs me, I'm here. The odd wave to a pensioner can do wonders for their self-esteem. Stop. Listen. No alarms. I want to live in a world where there aren't any alarms. An alarm-free world. Safe. Well, I think that most people know me around here. They know that I'm the home watch leader. I've got the certificates. And so they respect my authority. Probably some home watch business. Now, let's just come. Yeah, follow me. Yeah.
Oi! Are you the dickhead that's just took my son's ball?
Yeah.
Why? Because what? He's playing football in the street? Yeah? What's the problem? Have you ever played football before? Hey, you knobhead! What do you do all day?
Well, I'm the home watch leader.
Home watch my arse leader. And what do you do for that? Sit nosing out of the pissing window looking at people, you pervert. Hey, look at the state of you. Look at your jumper, your sandals. You can't even keep your glasses on your head, you dickhead. I bet you've never been out there in your life playing football, have you? No. You probably sat home playing board games, listening to Radio 4. Well, let me tell you. Next time my son's playing football and you try and take his ball off him, I'll pull your head off and use that as a football.
Right.
You knob. Now get in.
Okay. Thanks.
Go on.
Thanks. Well, I think we know where each other stands on that one. That's a typical incident where I told him exactly what the law was. I mean, not everybody can afford no ball game signs, you know. And I think he knows where the land lies now. I think he knows the boundaries. Is he still there? Still there. Of course, that's one of the other problems that we've got round here is disabled parking. Oh, that'll be Chin Fao. Bang on time as usual. He's, glad to see him actually this time. Oh, come in. Don't stand on ceremony. Let's.
You want to have a seat?
Yeah, it's a camera. It's a camera. Yeah.
We put VHS on, Mr. Suki.
Oh, rush hour again. Yeah.
Great. Brilliant.
Yeah, well, it's about the fourth time we've seen it, so.
你们在拍戏哈? Hey, Brian, 你明星了是吗?
He says hello.
Hey, 你们认不认识成龙? 成龙是我的偶像,你知道吗? Hey, 你们认识的话, 介绍给我好吗?
He says he likes going for walks in the park.
我们都会打的, 我们华人都很厉害打的。 我打给你看好吗? Huh?
He likes squirrels.
怎么样,可以吗?
I don't know. Anyway, let's. Why don't you tell them about the time you saw a local celebrity, Dev, in Debenhams? Go on.
Dev.
Yeah, that's it. Oh, it's all right, I'll tell them. Chin Fao saw local celebrity, Coronation Street star Dev, in Debenhams.
Dev.
And he's not been able to shut up about it, have you?
Dev.
Until today, when. You seem to have shut up about it. Doesn't matter. Let's go and watch Rush Hour. Again.
Brian has known Chin Fao now for over 10 years and is a regular visitor to his house. Although he speaks very little English, his relationship with Brian is very strong. Chin Fao actually living in the village wouldn't be quite right, but kindly Brian insists he lives just outside the village. We follow Brian to Sheila's house, who he co-organises a Christmas party with. After having gone through some traumatic times, Sheila has been housebound for several months and refuses to leave her house. Every morning, Brian goes round to get shopping for her and make sure she's all right.
Hi Sheila, it's Brian. It's Brian, love. How are you, love? Are you all right? How's John? How's his knees? I can't really hear. There's going to be a meeting at 1 o'clock at the village hall. Yeah. If you can make it, that's fine. If you can't, it doesn't matter. Do you want any shopping? I'm going to the shops later if you need any. What was that? Gammon? I don't know whether it's gammon or salmon. I'll get you something. Okay. All right. I'll see you later, love. See ya.
Broken one.
I'll go to the shops.